Pitch in, we
bought
your girl for your birthday.
Oh, yeah?
Here, one, two, three!
Charlie, two, win!
Big break,
two.
Oh!
Bank it up.
Set it up for yourself.
Really, yes, beautiful.
Come on.
That'd be me.
We're all right.
Clean it up.
Hey, brother. $5?
Hey, piss off, you drunken rummy. Get out of here.
Hey, come here. Look at me.
Hell, how about this?
I'll give you a nice, shiny new quarter if you look at me, huh? Look me in the eye. Come on, look at me. Most godless bunch of people I've ever seen in my life. Oh, you're looking in the eye.
Oh, beautiful. All right.
Don't give him a good leave, Charlie. Concentrate. You do this. Okay.
Hey, brother.
Get off me.
Hey. I'm sorry, brother.
I ain't your brother.
Hey, come on, you out of here. Come here. You got enough now, okay?
Let's go.
Come on, take a shot.
Yeah. Raining rummies here. Woo!
Wait, stop.
Why?
Stop, Charlie, stop. I have your birthday present. I have your birthday present.
My birthday's not till tomorrow.
Come on, open your present.
I'm opening my present.
Seven.
Yeah, so?
Wait, it's 7, and Shep said you're supposed to be there at 6:30. It's 7.
Oh, right? Okay. You know what? Hold on.
I'll be right back. Just give me 5 minutes.
All right.
We tried calling, but... Oh. Sorry.
Aren't you at least gonna eat? What about your present?
What?
Your present?
Yeah, right. I'll tell you what. As soon as I get back, I'll open it, okay? I promise. All right, I'm gonna call you. I'll be back before you know it. So you just help yourself to anything you need in the fridge. And, see ya.
Here you go, fellas. Green Mod Golf. We'll set up your first camp right by the ocean.
go that far?
Cover the territories, every bloody inch.
Morning, fellas. Miss anything?
Wow. It's a beaut. What is it? Cessna?
She's a Norseman.
Right. So you got the pontoons on?
Floats.
Right.
Would you excuse us a second? Hey, Charlie.
Yeah?
Knock it off.
What?
You know what? Now knock it off.
Come on, these guys are a couple of cupcakes here. I'm just trying to have fun.
Now, look, this is a really big contract. You piss those guys off, they're going to take their business someplace else.
Oh, bullshit. They ain't going nowhere.
Oh, yeah? Well, you just make sure that they don't.
Speaking of which, how about a little detour after my run?
Where?
Bathurst.
Oh, yeah.
Why?
Business.
Oh, yeah.
What kind of business?
Oh, a little business. Business. Two or three days, I'm in, I'm out. Make it worth your while.
Two.
Three.
Two. And you let me know where you are.
All right.
And try to keep those guys happy, will you?
Hey, get your suit all dirty.
Oh,
it's kind of grimy up here.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
So, you've been flying long?
I guess the better part of 12 years.
He's my best pilot. Flew in the war.
Oh. Africa? No, Europe. Flew Boston's and mosquitoes mostly. Yeah, I bombed the hell out of Mannheim and Bremen. Hell, I would have sunk the Bismarck to give me half a chance.
I was infantry myself.
Well, sir, you have my sympathies. So you have a co-pilot you work with?
Sure do. Like the book says, God.
Heavy little buggers, huh? Sure didn't expect to see anybody here. You fellas like chocolate?
eat this stuff? Thanks again. Okay, anime.
Come.
Huh?
Come.
What do you got there?
Please, come.
You got some pelts? Little white fox? What, wanna do a little trading? Yeah, sure, what the hell. Is she your girlfriend or your sister?
Well,
she's sick. I can't do anything for her. And she's got TB or something. You know, tuberculosis?
You, yellow knife.
Huh? No, I'm not even going straight back. I can't take her. You take her back to her village. You got a medicine man or something, don't you? I mean, the hospitals in Yellowknife are full. Huh? She stay.
Sorry,
what do you got there?
Holy smokes.
A lot of money right there.
Yellow knife.
All right, shit. I'm deadheading anyway. But you hurry, all right? We got a storm brewing. So, Gavavi.
Gavavi, is that your nacht?
Oh, dag, man.
Kan we daar niet zitten? Kan we daar niet zitten?
Oh,
dag, man, nama.
Give me your government number there. Eskimo tag in case I get a hold of you. B51254. All right. This her stuff? Okay. Wami! Come on. Okay, here. There. Up. There you go.
Come on.
Yellow knife!
Yeah, Yellowknife. I said I'd take her to Yellowknife. Just come visit her in the spring. Bring her a potted plant. Days, I guess, huh? Coffee?
The hell with it. What do you say we screw Bathurst, head straight for home? Get around this miserable weather. Funny thing is, I was just going there to sell off those crates of soda, maybe scrounge up some ivory, and kinda got that covered. Life is funny that way.
You might as well get out. She's broken. She smashed to hell. You understand? Don't fly no more.
fishing. What the hell kind of fish are you gonna catch in here?
This is Juliet, India, November. Does anyone read? Does anyone read? Warren, do you copy? Bathurst, Baker Lake, anyone?
No. Hey, hey, easy with that.
No. Get out of here with that. I'm
trying to...
Oh.
You know what?
No, just... Just go.
You eat it if you're gonna eat it like that. Go.
You speak any English? You speak any English? Yes, no, a little bit. No. Well, I don't know if you understand our situation here, but we're in a hell of a bind. See, nobody knows where the hell we are. The reason being is I didn't stick to my flight plan. My radio's busted. I can't call out. Try and fix it in the morning, but I think my tools are on the bottom of that lake somewhere. So I'm just saying, there's a good chance nobody's gonna show up. Okay. Good talking to you.
Hey, Chef. Still no sign of him. I'm starting to think.
No sign of who? Charlie?
Yeah. He just got a little delayed by the weather, that's all. Now, why would you want to go say something like that in front of her for, huh?
I didn't know she was standing right here.
Jesus, Carl. You know Charlie's got women stashed all over the bloody map?
I know, but still, shouldn't we have heard something by now?
Hey, don't worry about it. He's fine. I start worrying about Charlie Halliday 5 minutes after hell freezes over. I'll tell you one thing. He better be having one hell of a good time.
No! 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 Hey, there's a town a couple hundred miles east of here. I'm gonna head for it. All right? I left you some grub. I'll be back in about a week.
Pisung na kano?
What?
Pisung na kano?
No, it's too far. You stay, okay? You stay here. I'll send a plane to get you. Right? I'll be back in a little bit.
Thank you. Another 24.
Juliet, India, November, over.
Second it does. Pierce, I want you and Carl to go to the Gulf. You take the Stinson, cover west towards Bathurst.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Denny hasn't seen him either.
Bathurst?
He's not at Coppermine or Cambridge Bay, but I can't raise Anubis. Right. Can you drive him over?
Sorry. It's Frankie over at the station. They want to make him an official missing person.
Yeah, okay.
Thank you.
Oh, shit. What the hell?
Akka! Akka Pinitsu!
What the hell are you doing here?
Pinitsu.
Hey, did you follow me? Hey, did you follow me?
Shh.
Did you follow me here?
Sleep.
Did you walk here?
Sleep.
What, do you speak English?
Little bit. Mirelek. Eat.
Thank you. Oh. Oh, that's good. That's good. The enemy. Where did you get this? Huh? What is this?
Sick, sick.
Sick, sick. What's sick, sick?
Sick, sick. What?
You catch this?
Mm.
Where the hell did you find this? And I don't even know your name. What's your name? No, not your tag. Your name. What do I call you?
Kanala.
Charlie. Nice to meet you.
Here we go, Cherry. Look alive.
Fishing camp. Huskies. What are you doing?
Lunch. Hi, don't you ever eat, Cherry?
Don't call me that.
How long you been up here?
A couple months.
Yeah, it's different, isn't it? How big do you think it is, the territory? Half a million? A million miles? You know, you could put all of Europe in here three times and still have enough room for Greenland.
What are you talking about?
Charlie was where he was supposed to be. Why is Shep sending people to Bathurst?
Maybe the plane's under the water. Crashed on descent or something.
How'd the barrels get on the beach?
Right. Well, something else then.
You know, maybe it was murder. Maybe the Huskies killed him. And then they ate him. And then they ate his plane.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing.
Let's go find the poor son of a bitch.
Here, little souvenir.
Kamalu.
Old boots.
Old boots.
You want some water?
Yeah, do you want some?
Imak.
Imak.
Water.
Hot.
Atata.
Oh, atata.
Imak.
Water?
Drink.
Oh, drinking is imek?
Mm.
Water is imak? Mm.
Drink. Imek.
What's that?
Amek. Sik sik.
Amek, imek, amek, and imak?
Water, imak. Imek.
I'm never going to remember all this.
Hey, what are you doing?
What's your merde?
What?
Fix it.
No, not right now. Wait, I need those. Come back. Kanawa! Come back!
Okay, thanks.
What about up here, north of Slave Lake?
I think the government boys have already flown.
I don't give a damn. I'm telling you where I want you to go.
Fine.
Pierce, through the back river, in case he cuts straight down.
Why would he?
Shep, here she is.
Hello, Mrs. Halliday. This is Walter Shepherd up in Yellowknife. I work with your son. I don't exactly know how to say this. I always hoped I'd never have to make this call.
Some fish. You're some.
For you.
No, you don't have to do that. No, these boots are still fine. Put a few stitches in them, they'll take me a few more miles. You should rest, you know?
That's it. I gotta go back.
Maybe we ought to push it a little bit.
No.
Look at the gauge. We got the fuel. Just 5 more minutes. Just look at the gauge.
What do you think this is? A game? What are you, some kind of goddamn boy scout?
What are you talking about, Pierce? You think I don't know what's going on here? You think I don't really see what's going on? Why don't you just come out and say it?
Say what?
You don't want to find him.
You dumbass kid. Charlie Halliday's dead. He was an arrogant, selfish son of a bitch who got sloppy, and now he's dead. Take a look out there. Go on, just look down below. You see that? That's death, boy. This land will kill you as sure as a bullet in the head. We just run this little drill to make Saul feel better. Because next time, who knows, it could be my ass, or Shepard's, or yours.
He would have done the same for us.
What?
He would have done the same for us.
You're goddamn right he would. But that don't change the facts.
The way I figured is I'd probably walk for 5 days. Maybe, I don't know, 15, 20 miles a day. So that would put us probably 80, 90 miles from the plane. So if Shep is flying a triangular grid from Queen Maud Gulf, Bathurst, Yellowknife, and that was them, and they're flying east, they'd see the plane. I mean, they'd see the SOS, and then they'd know we're alive. But no, you know, we're here in the middle of bloody nowhere because I left the plane. Shit! You never, never, never leave the plane! You know, I know it was them. We gotta go back.
You know, you're gonna cut my circulation off there.
Ayumi Tuma. Imare.
Sheesh. All right.
I'm
a bloody invalid. I'm good. I got it. I'm good.
Pio.
All right, let's go back to camp.
Aka, imare.
No, I'm not going
imare.
In the water.
Are you
no.
I'm
gonna get
it's
soaked.
Okay. It's okay.
Oh.
Pio. Imare siete.
Huh. How about that? Watertight.
I got boots.
Married. I used to have a girl. That was a while ago.
How old?
32.
32, no wife?
Well, how old are you?
Avati.
Avati, 20? How about you? You got a wife?
Taima. Yeah, you've been singing the same song for 3 days now. I mean, have mercy, woman. Man can only take so much of this. Do you know any other songs? Do you, you know anything with like a tune or a beat?
You sing.
Nah, no, that's not what I meant.
You sing now.
All right.
Fine, I'll sing.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
Bells ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing a ring, bella. Scusa me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore. That's amore.
So?
Sit down. Search and rescue called. They've been at it for almost 3 weeks now. And you know what they say about them? They have a perfect record. They've never found anybody. The country is just so big, you know. And if, God forbid, the plane burned, they could fly right over the top of it and never see anything at all.
Go.
I'm sorry, kid.
Hey,
You okay?
Here, sit down. Just rest a while. What the hell's that? It's not the plane. You see that? Good God. Sweet Jesus, look at this. I think this is a Beach 18. Sure took a tumble. Look at all this stuff. Come look at this. Come here. Use some of this. Look up in here. All kinds of stuff. Yeah. Use that. Uh-huh. Get the jackpot here. Kill a few squirrels with that, huh? Come on, there's all kinds of it. Give me a hand. It's okay. It's okay. Poor son of a bitch. Too bad. Use it for something. Come on. Come on, give me a hand. Oh, yeah. Jackpot. Look at that. Thank you. Oh, that's gonna save us right there. We were meant to find this stuff, Canala. Would you at least look at me? I'm talking to you. Would you look at me? He doesn't need these things, you know.
نون عجاب وأنا نوني قوم. World has many spirits. All things unknown.
Breath. Everything breathes.
Some spirits good. Ikayokjue. Some bad. They trick you. Vangaru. When you die, Takut will come.
Who's that? Who's Tarkik? Is he a spirit?
He Tautusu.
He sees you? He watches you?
He says, Malilere, come. It's okay. It's your time now. It's okay.
Where does he take you when he comes?
Good hunting. Many seals, fish, ivy.
Walrus?
Ivy.
Sounds like a good place.
When you die, you need Bekuti.
I need your tools. I see. So, where does Tarkik live?
Takpika Tarkik. Tautukto. Taka.
Hey.
Oh. I was just trying to figure out whose dog that is. You off work?
No, just a break. I told Jimmy I needed some air. I wanted to tell you something. I know you feel bad, Shep, but this wasn't your fault. You weren't responsible for him. Nobody was. And when it comes right down to it, all of us are just alone in this world, and that's just the way it is. Oh, I brought you something. I thought you might like to have it.
What are you doing?
Getting my stuff. I heard they called off the search.
Yeah.
That's a tough break. Listen, if you're looking for another flyer, I got a buddy of mine you might want to meet. He and I are partners in a couple of side deals we got going. I do a little speculating now and again myself, you know. Matter of fact, you know, we should talk. Because, you know, maybe we could work out a little arrangement.
Get out.
What?
You heard me. Go on, get the hell out of here. Before I throw you through the goddamn wall.
Thank you.
Look! Look! Ha ha ha! Ha ha! That cookie! Thank God! That cookie! Look at her! How could you miss her? Come on. I know you guys left supper. All right. Come on, fellas. I know you left the note. Where is it?
Come on, Chef. Cheers.
Nothing. Not a note, not a sign, nothing. How could they miss this? How could they not see us? You know, the snow's coming. What's it gonna get, 20, 40 below? How are we gonna eat then, huh? How are we gonna stay alive? I don't even know why you came for me. Well, you know what the real joke is? We never had a chance. We were dead the minute we hit the ground.
I said leave me alone.
Thank you.
Gertrude.
What?
Took to a Gertrude. Two of you.
What is that?
Geeks out.
It's like fat.
Geeks out.
Yeah, you eat this?
Mama Rilara.
It's pretty good.
What do you do? Una usto caro.
Oh.
I was just thinking about this steakhouse in Montreal called Moishe's. I used to always go there with the fellas from my outfit. And I'm telling you, no word of a lie, these steaks in this joint were at least 5 inches thick. They had it all, boy. They had, you know, top sirloin, New York, ribeye. And you walk in there and you could smell it wafting through the joint, sizzling on the grill. And they'd come to the table with these giant spuds, you know, just swimming in butter and sour cream and chives and fried onions and mushrooms. And the wine just flowing like bloody spring water. Of course, you know, the fellas would get a little tight, start getting lit up on the sauce and start, you know, jaw wagging about all the crazy dumbass shit we did during the war. Those were good times. Funny thing, you know, what war does to some people. You know, you think you know a fella and seems perfectly normal, then one day just the hammer drops and he snaps, you know, just falls all to pieces. Just because of what we saw over there, you know, what we saw during the war. You never, in your wildest dreams, thought you'd see stuff like that. And you never thought you could do the things you did. And things you just grow to hate yourself for. But somehow you make your peace with it. At least you try.
Soon, we walk.
Canola pea.
Cunning.
Here, put this around you.
Cunning.
Oh, damn. Aka, aka. That's enough for today. Oh, shit, you burned up. It's okay. It's okay. You just pushed yourself too hard today. How you doing, right?
I'm okay.
Good.
There was a small girl. Ilagi.
Family. Family hunting. She was hunting with her family.
Father.
Father was hurt. Couldn't hunt. The storm, snow.
Many days, nothing to do. Atanga, talking mupiyoyo. Took father, mother. Iglumi, aniluni pisusiyo.
She went away to die because there was no food. More food for her. Children.
Sister was dying. So the girl. Daring killer sooning in Nukane Kimiria.
You fed her with your blood. And what happened?
People came.
But Tuckick never came.
Tricked him.
Feel you.
Yeah, I figure we just keep heading north and we're bound to run into a hunting party or a village sooner or later. And I can radio for a medevac, get you straight into a hospital. I'll take care of you in a hospital. They got good medicine since the war. I tell you another thing, we're not going to Yellowknife neither. Take you to the big city, like Edmonton. You been to the city? Oh, you wouldn't believe your eyes. There's cars and people everywhere, all over the streets.
Millions of kavlunas everywhere.
Moishis?
Huh?
Moishis.
Oh, no, that's in Montreal. But, you know, same thing in Edmonton. Listen, I'll tell you what. As soon as you get out of the hospital, I'll take you for a big steak dinner. All right? All the mushrooms.
I didn't know Charlie Halliday for very long, but I do know he was a good pilot and a good friend. We are gathered here today because he was taken from us much too soon. Words are cold comfort when a young life is cut so short. But I thought I might read from a poem I found, written by a young Canadian flight lieutenant named John McGee during the war, and found in his locker after he was shot down. Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the skies on laughter-silvered wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit silence. Hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air, up, up the long, delirious, burning blue. I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, where never lark or even eagle flew. And while with silent, lifting mind, I've trod the high, untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touch the face of God.
Good night.